Stuart, nice to meet you. Have you found yourself a home here?
Yeah, definitely. I've really enjoyed my time here so far. It's been a good start to the season. And yeah, just hope that it can continue.
Does it feel good to be back as a number one?
Yeah, 100%. Obviously, last few years I haven't played as much as I would have wanted to. And that was a big thing for me this season, obviously, coming in. I really wanted to start the season. So, obviously, I've done that and hopefully can continue to play now.
Are you grateful for Morecambe for recruiting you in the summer? Because I imagine you got towards the end of last season thinking, what's next?
Yeah, definitely. I think whenever you come out of contract at any club, it's always that sort of uncertainty. It's not nice. Obviously, we're speaking to a few clubs, but it's just the case of, you never know where you're going to be. So when the opportunity arose, obviously, I wanted to grab it with both hands.
Derek Adams been good so far?
Yeah, it's been very good. Yeah, Gaffer's been excellent, to be fair. Tactically, he knows what he wants, and he knows what he wants from his players physically and mentally as well. So you know where you stand with him, which is good. So yeah, Gaffer's been class.
How much work goes into the tactics and the game plan? Because it is a brand new team. You're one of several new players.
Yeah. I think every game we obviously, we do things the same, but obviously tactics are different. So we always look at the previous game and how we did, what we could do better, and then that's very quickly forgotten and moved on to the next one because the games are coming thick and fast. So, as soon as that game's over, we're already preparing for the next game.
Can I just take you back to your time at Blackpool? Was it difficult to be number three? Did you have to accept the fact you were number three? How was that?
Yeah, I think it was difficult, to be honest. It was never really sort of stated, it just sort of happened. I was quite unfortunate at times. But I think it's just part of one of those things. Being a goalkeeper, there's one position, and obviously it's a game of opinion. So it's you find yourself in a difficult situation, but you've got to stay strong mentally, which I did, and you've always got to be prepared because obviously you never know when you're going to get that opportunity to play, because the game changes very quickly. So for me, it was just a more of a mental one. Just stay on top of my game, stay fit, and obviously when the opportunity does arise, hopefully I'll be ready for it.
How did you stay strong mentally in that situation?
To be fair, I'm very lucky with my family. I've got great support around me. Obviously, my brother plays as well. He's been in similar situations, so it helps to talk about it. So there'd be times, obviously, when you are down, you are gutted, but you just sort of pick yourself up and you just think, you know what? I'm doing it for myself. Like, I've got to be ready if the opportunity comes. I don't want to be, unprepared and that. So yeah, it is a tough thing, and it's tough for anyone that's obviously out the side, but for yourself, I think being a professional footballer, you have to have that professionalism and you have to be mentally ready at all times.
Did you have to have honest conversations with the management team at Blackpool about the situation and being behind Daniel Grimshaw and Chris Maxwell?
Yeah, there's many a times I spoke to, obviously we had a couple of different managers throughout the time, and I was quite lucky that every manager was open, so anytime I needed to speak to him, the door was open, and I'd always go speak to him, have an honest conversation, and sometimes you get the answers you want, sometimes you don't, but I guess that's just part of football really. But yeah, it definitely does help to speak about these situations.
Were Daniel Grimshaw and Chris Maxwell good to work with? Did you develop by just working with them on a daily basis on the training pitch?
Yeah, we were very lucky. We did have a good goalkeeper group there. Obviously, the talent was exceptional. So, both of them work very hard. They're both very good goalkeepers. So, you just sort of push each other every day and strive to be your best. And obviously, you want to try and be better than the rest. So, yeah, we had a great group.
There was that time, wasn't where you did play a game against Blackburn Rovers and Blackpool won that game, but then the manager went for Grimshaw afterwards, didn't he? Was that really hard to take, that moment where you thought you might get in because Maxwell was injured at the time, wasn't he?
Yeah, it was difficult to take. Like I said, it's a game of opinions. I felt I was quite hard done by on that situation, but you just got to forget it and pick yourself up. And yeah, obviously, it would have been nice to play. Felt I'd worked hard, done well when I come in and deserved the chance. But for whatever reason, I didn't get that chance. And obviously, that was down to the manager. So there wasn't really much I could do about it. But obviously, yeah, it was frustrating.
Did you ever lose your love for the game at all in that time? Did you maybe need that loan spell at the end of the season to give you the zest back for it? Or is that the wrong way to put it?
I don't think it's a case of losing the love for the football. I think there's times where it's hard because obviously you do work towards that game at the end of the week, and when you're not involved, it is difficult because you're just constantly working. So, you know, getting to the game at the weekend, that's what you're working towards. And when there is no game for you, yeah, it does become difficult. You just get caught in a bit of a cycle. But again, I think that's where it comes in with the mentality, and you've got to be mentally tough to be able to deal with it. So, yeah, there were tough times where obviously I didn't enjoy it as much, but I don't think I ever really lost the love for the game.
Yeah, because you sat in the stands as well. It's not like you're on the bench and you've got a chance to come on. That must have been. It's been really tough for you.
Yeah, it's tough. It's something that usually happens sort of when you're a younger goalkeeper and you sort of learn in your trade. So to happen as I'm a bit older and a bit more experienced, it was tough. But like I said, if you keep at it, these tough times don't last. Eventually you will get a breakthrough, whether it's at that club or somewhere else. And yeah, like I say, coming here was a perfect opportunity for me to do that.
I want to go back to your childhood, because you've got a brother, Simon, who plays for Coventry. You're both goalkeepers. How did that work in the family? Did you have to take it in turns in goal in the back garden, or is that too simplistic to look at it that
yeah,
way?
Yeah, to be fair, it was one of those. My dad used to be a goalkeeper as well, and then his dad, so I guess it just runs in the family. But right. Yeah, it's never forced upon us. To just love diving around, getting muddy when I was younger, and obviously watching my brother and my dad grow up, just wanted to be just like them. So yeah, we did take it in turns in the garden, and you know, going over the field and practicing, we'd be shooting against each other. So I guess it was quite tough, but at the same time it was very good, because we had something to talk about, and we knew obviously if someone did something wrong, we'd be able to talk about it. And yeah, like I say, I've always been helped from my brother and my dad in that respect of, they've always wanted me to do the best, and they've obviously known what they're talking about when I was younger. So yeah, my upbringing was brilliant, so I was very fortunate.
You grew up on the Isle of Wight, right?
Yeah. Good. So it's a lovely place, lovely part of the world. If you ever get a chance to visit, it's brilliant.
Yeah,
but yeah, it's if you want to do anything with yourself, work-wise or sport-wise, you have to get off the island, really. It's too enclosed, but it's a lovely place to go visit. But yeah, once you get older, obviously, you know, it's nicer to get off and explore.
Have you had to sort of reset up north and build a life for yourself up here? Because you've been up here a long time now, haven't you?
Yeah, I've been quite fortunate that I've been around here the last few years. I think that's one of the toughest things as a footballer, is not knowing where you're going to be next. So trying to sort of put some roots down is almost impossible. So for me to be up here the last few years, I've managed to obviously settle down, get a house, and it's made a big difference, to be fair, because for the early part of my career, that was one of the big things that I struggled with, obviously constantly moving around. So yeah, it's nice to obviously be able to stay at home now and travel in.
You must feel at a good age to progress. You must, the Morecambe have probably looked at it and think, you've got a good mental strength given what you've done and the clubs that you've been at and what you've been through and all that kind of stuff, the stuff that we've just discussed. So that sets you in good stead already, doesn't it, for a successful time?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I've been through most things in football now, to be fair, so nothing surprises me. You know, nothing really phases me. Whatever happens, I just get on with it. And, you know, it's one of the things you learn to deal with as you go through the game. Luckily, you know, I've had a lot of different experiences, some good, some bad. And, you know, it's just how you react from them. And that's what the biggest thing I've probably learned from all of this.
Just finally, you've got another game this weekend against Bradford City. You've had a decent start. What are you anticipating this weekend from a team managed by a legend of the game in Mark Hughes?
Yeah, it's going to be a difficult game. I mean, they've all been tough games so far. I think the boys have been brilliant with how we've done. So it's just another game coming up. So every game in this league's tough, I think. So we just have to take it one by one and just hope that we can get the result. Get money for your old phone. Mazuma Mobile.com.